Hello everyone. I'm Dr. Geetu, working as a microbiologist at Dinanath Mangeshkar Hospital and Research Center, Pune. Today I would like to share some information about the novel coronavirus infection that has occurred at Wuhan city of China. As of today, the WHO has declared the outbreak as a global health emergency, currently affecting 27 countries with close to 1,200 deaths. It was initially named as novel coronavirus 19. However, the WHO has officially renamed it as COVID-19. Coronaviruses belong to a large family of viruses that cause illnesses ranging from common cold to the severe acute respiratory illness. The name coronaviruses is derived from Latin, which refers to the crown-like shape of the viruses. The spread of coronaviruses occur via droplets, through an infected person coughing or sneezing, by touching an infected person's hands or face, or by touching surfaces on which the infected people's droplets have fallen, such as doorknobs. On December 31, 2019, the Chinese health authorities informed the World Health Organization about the alarming cases of pneumonia occurring due to unknown etiology. The new virus was named as the novel coronavirus. Sometimes the coronaviruses can infect both animals and humans. There are various forms of coronaviruses occurring in animals or being carried by animals which have not yet affected the humans or not yet been transmitted to humans. When such a transmission occurs, it is called as a spillover event. In case of the novel coronavirus infection, the current investigation suggests that this has originated from bats. However, no bats were sold at the Hunan seafood market, which suggests that another yet to be identified animal has acted as a stepping stone between the bats and the humans. Some examples of such spillover events that have occurred in the past are 1. The SARS-CoV infection, severe acute respiratory syndrome coronavirus, which has occurred in China in 2002, which has originated from bats and civet cats. The MERS-CoV infection, Middle East Respiratory Syndrome Coronavirus infection that has occurred in Saudi Arabia, which has originated from camels. 3. The Nipah virus infection, which has occurred in Kerala, India, which has originated from fruit bats. The symptoms of coronavirus infection are similar to any other respiratory tract infection, such as running nose, cough, sore throat, and sometimes a fever. In the initial cases, we will not be able to differentiate it from any other regular cold-causing virus, such as rhinovirus. But once the novel coronavirus spreads into the lower respiratory tract, such as your windpipe and your lungs, then it may cause a severe pneumonia, respiratory distress, or even death. The incubation period of the virus, that is the time taken from the entry of the virus to the onset of symptoms, is estimated to be somewhere between 2 and 12 days. We may be dealing with three case scenarios. One is a suspect case where a person has severe acute respiratory illness with a history of travel to Wuhan in the last 14 days. Second is a probable case where a person has acute respiratory illness with a known close physical contact with a confirmed case. So what is a confirmed case? A confirmed case is a laboratory confirmation of 2019 novel coronavirus infection. Currently, there are no drugs or vaccines available for the novel coronavirus infection. So the control measures that have to be followed are thorough and frequent hand washing, use of gowns, gloves, goggles and respirators by the healthcare workers, isolation of the affected people, quarantine of the exposed people, avoiding close personal contact, such as touching or sharing utensils with the affected patients, travel restrictions if needed. There are other theories that surface the social media that it originated from snakes. Another theory suggests that it may have been bioengineered. Keeping the rumors aside, we are faced with two mortal challenges, short-term and long-term. Short-term is that we must do everything we can, with intelligence, with calm, and a full commitment of resources to contain and extinguish this novel coronavirus 2019 outbreak, before it could become a global devastating pandemic. Long-term challenge is that we must remember, when the dust settles, that the novel coronavirus 2019 was not a novel event or a misfortune that befell us. It was and it is a part of the choices that we humans are making. So this goes to prove what Dr. Chen and his team, in their study back in 2007, speculated that the presence of a large reservoir of SARS-CoV-like viruses in bats, along with the culture of eating exotic mammals in southern China, is a time bomb. So be safe, do not panic. Take common sense precautions. As frightening as this time is, we will get through it. Take care and see you in the next one. If you have learned something from this video, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel.